Hello everyone, this is Aida Domisiewicz from 13 Arts and I am gonna present you my modeling paste today. And I would like to show you some cool tips and techniques which I use. The modeling paste is white and it will stay white when it's dry. And it's very smooth, very thick, and I really like this product. So let me show you what can you do with a modeling paste from 13 Arts. Of course, the most popular techniques, which all the scrappers perfectly know, is putting some modeling paste through the stencils. I'm using 13 Arts stencils, as you can see. I'm gonna choose the love one with the branch and leaves, and just using your spatula or any other tool, just put the paste through the stencil. You can see it will stay really smooth and white, and it will give your project a really great texture. So just using different stencils, you can achieve really great effects with only the white paste. But then you will see that it's not the only one. It's not the only thing you can use it for. So you can use this for the background, or just over the photo, or the card, or our journal. It's really up to you. So this was the most popular technique. The other one is just making a texture with your craft knife or spatula. So as you can see, you can just play with this texture with different ways. You can draw in it, you can just play and play as long as you will achieve the effects you are happy with. So the thicker the layer is, the thicker is the effect you will achieve. So just perfect for art journaling, for canvases. I'm using the canvas here, so you can see. You can just make a really great background for it, for your canvas. You can then add the photo or any embellishments, but the background is really, really textured and nice. So, as you can see, I'm playing and just showing you that you can get whatever you want with this modeling paste and just a spatula, no other tools at this moment. So what else can we do? We can make our own paste with let's say they called it coarse paste or gravy with you can see there are lots of pastes on the market, but I think you don't have to buy them all. Because when you've got this product, you can just add some glass beads. I'm using 13 Arts D2. I mean, this diameter is 2 millimeters. So these bigger ones, glass beads, you can add just the small glass beads also. This is a glass microspheres, it's called here in 13 Arts. And you've got your own textured coarse paste. So you don't have to buy everything. Of course, I like different products too, but if you don't have any at home, you just can mix the paste with sand, with sugar, with salt, or beads, or anything you've just got at home, and you've got nice and great texture for your projects. So this is a great technique to use, and I just love to add glass beads to my projects, as you can already. I hope you've seen many projects with this. So this is a very cool technique, and the next what I will show you is making some colorful paste. So you also don't have to buy everything, which is of course there are many ready to use products, but if you don't have any, or you just don't want to buy everything, you can just mix your paste with ink or mist. You can use, I'm using water ink from 13 Arts, but you can also use acrylic ink or any acrylic paint. You can use paint, you can use mists, you can use inks, and just mix them all together very well, and you will receive your own colorful paste, which is great for your projects. So I am just putting it over the mask, over the stencil here, and you will see it's great, colorful, textured background. You can also play the same way with your colorful paste as with your white one. So just as you can see, I'm playing with different ways. I'm using the knife. You can achieve very, very cool effects. So I'm making another color. This time I want to have pink, so I'm mixing, I think it's Bordeaux mist, pearl mist this time. So just mix it all well. You can use spatula, you can use a brush. Okay, I think it's a little bit too liquid, so I will add some more modeling paste into it and mix it all together again. So here you can see it's really, really nice and smooth pink, beautiful paste you can also use to your projects. I will use the same mask, the same stencil with leaves. There you go. Right. And the stencil was a little bit wet, I think, from the white paste, but it works very well too. If you don't want to color the paste before you apply it, you can also color it after you will you apply the white paste, so we can do it both ways. We can mix the color with the paste, and another way is just put some white paste any way you like, and then just color it over the top, so you can use then inks or mists or whatever you like. Here I'm added a little bit of gel medium. So if you want to make a different paste, a little bit more shiny and more glossy, and I added a little bit of glass beads again, so you can see another product. You can just make it all by yourself at home. No need to buy every single type of modeling paste. Okay. So I prefer to add glass beads over the paste, but you can mix it with the paste and then apply it, whatever you prefer. So the next technique, like I told you, you can also color the paste over the top. When the paste is wet, it will take some of the color into it. Or you can just dry it, and then the paste will not absorb as much color. I very often add a color into the wet paste because I like this effect, but of course the a little bit different effect will be when the paste is dry, and then you can spray it. Now I just played with some texture, and I added some mist. I think it's chalk turquoise, and then I added some water, and I'm just playing with background. Here you can see with the differences between two different ways of mixing the color. The blue, the pink one is mixed in the jar before applying, and here is just sprayed over the paste. And now I, after I added some water, I can play with my heating gun and make some cool, very cool platters, I think I can call it. So, as you can see, with just one product, we have endless possibilities to use on our backgrounds. Of course, that's not all. We can use many different tools, but I think I will show you this next time. So now, just look how easily you can make a textured background for your layout using the techniques I have shown you before. So the blue paste and the 13 art stencil. Okay, then playing with some texture, so I can use this paste a little bit lighter effect when you just take your stencil and just put it onto your paper again, and just playing, you know, it's just making texture, making fun, right? Just spatula, and now the navy blue, navy blue ink, just again over the top, and some water, and the techniques and this technique I have shown you before, with some water, ink and heating gun, and playing again. All right, very, very cool technique, I really love it. A little bit messy, but still fun. And now the ink Bordeaux, and the same way with water and heating gun, some splashes, some, and the pink paste through the stencil, and without the stencil, just playing with it. So I will show you the effect when all is dry. I will put a photo and maybe some embellishments, and the very, very easy way to achieve a great background for your layout. So thank you very much for watching, and I hope I will make another video for you next time, and I will show you different products and different techniques. So thank you for today.